Kentucky owes atheist $1,051. Sorry. I can't see.
You can't do numbers.
I've got to pick it up. $151,206.74.
Right.
After rejecting his I'm God license plate. Sorry, I couldn't see. I didn't wear my glasses.
No worries.
After telling an atheist he wasn't allowed to have an I'm God license plate, the state of Kentucky will have to pay him more than $150,000 in attorney fees and litigation costs.
Wow.
This case began in 2016 when the head of Kentucky's Division of Motor Vehicles rejected Benny Hart's request to get the personalized license plate, although he had it without incident in Ohio, where he had lived for the previous 12 years. That's when he filed a lawsuit with the help of ACLU of Kentucky and the Freedom From Religion Foundation. Last November, the case was all but settled. The same judge that said that Kentucky officials went too far in rejecting Hart's plate request and that personalized license plate aren't just for University of Kentucky fans. All of that was left was deciding how much money the state owed Hart for his troubles, and it was a lot. So he also, his one of the arguments that the lawyer used was that he had the I am God statement on his personal plate, but it's on a plate that says In God We Trust, which is pretty funny, which is also what his Ohio plate said. So they're saying, well, look, the state's already put God on a license plate, and they've waded into the matter. So the state's not saying, you can't say that you can't put God on there. You've already done it. And now you're deciding how a person can put it on there. There's no obscenity. You're deciding about subjecting his religion and his beliefs to individual interpretation, and the court found for the guy.
That's great. Good job, court. Wait, what kind of court? Was this the Kentucky court or like any Supreme?
Uh-huh.
That's great.
Yeah.
Good job.
Yeah, it's it's a Supreme Court of Kentucky, I believe.
Wow. Is it Kentucky?
State. It's the state, but yeah. But they're Supreme Court, I think. So, yeah, and Freedom From Religion Foundation did a lot of this work. And most
Yay,
of the
thank you.
Fees go to $150,715 of it are in attorney's fees. And $491.24 are just the litigation costs, which is probably the filing fees and stuff.
I mean, so this guy got nothing himself, though. He just went to
his Except for his license plate that he wanted.
Okay, but so look at this guy. This guy's a hero because he did mm-hmm. all of this trouble, not because he wanted anything for himself. He set a precedent. He's fighting for your rights. You might think mm-hmm. this license plate is not a big deal, but this is about putting religion in its place. This is about mm-hmm. not giving a privilege to any ideology over atheism or any other beliefs, right? So it's not just this is not just for him. This is for the rest of you ungrateful morons who don't appreciate this, what this guy is doing for him. All the money that he made went to the cost and trouble, and not for his time. Did it go for his time?
It's $151,000, and $150,000 of it is going to attorney's fees.
Right. So, like, the cost. So this guy, even after all the money that he made from this, it was still a net cost for him. Because all of that went to his lawyers and all the attorney fees, but he still put time and resources and energy on this for you ungrateful mother effers that will never see this guy as a lot of you are not going to see this guy. These are people are like this.
3 years worth of effort.
3 years worth of effort. People are like this are why you have rights, many rights that you enjoy in your country that you don't know other people have worked for it, right? This is definitely not just about this guy's license plate. This is making sure that the walls that we have trying to uphold around religion are not cracking, because they are cracking, but people like this are holding it for you, and you guys need to be more grateful, and you guys need to support organizations like the Freedom From Religion Foundation who are doing these kind of work, because they are one of the only ones at the front line of this, okay? This is why United States is not Saudi effing Arabia, okay? This is because people, I mean, not even close, but this is because of people like this, because of people like this at the front lines are holding the wall, okay? Share these stories like this, and if you can, support organizations that are doing this. And also support Atheist Republic, link in the description, because we're sharing you the story.
Atheist Republic, definitely support Atheist Republic, but also I can't say enough good things about Freedom From Religion Foundation.
Yes.
They have 11, and they may have even hired more, attorneys that work all over the United States continuously working on cases like this, sending cease and desist orders to school districts, to municipalities, helping people with license plates, continuously helping maintain the wall of separation between church and state, maintaining our First Amendment rights. Because, you know, Kentucky, at first when they denied him the plate, they said that it was obscene or vulgar. But then they said it wasn't in good taste. So they kept changing
vulgar. Wow, these people. Great.
Right, but that didn't work because they already have the word God on their plates that they put, you know, in God we trust. So, but they also have a really overbroad and ambiguous statute about they can decide what's tasteful or not. But again, the attorneys are saying, you know, that other people have religious messages on their plates. So he, as an atheist, has a First Amendment right to comment on religion. And then again, the argument is great by them putting God on the plate. They've made a comment in religion, and they've opened the door to God being on plate, so therefore this guy can do it. And I think that's a really good argument.
Right. So AKL561 is saying Freedom From Religion Foundation rocks. It definitely does. And BJ is also saying it does. Yes. I mean, I don't know if any other organization that has been this influential in upholding the wall. I think it's just like the main force against religion creeping in your lives is the Freedom From Religion Foundation in the United States. So any support that you have, that you give them, is going to be worth your while. However, here's a comment, and the top comment is by Frank. And Frank is saying, well, this is all well and good. Isn't it taxpayers that are going to foot the bill for this frivolous lawsuit?
It's not frivolous. He was denied his First Amendment rights.
Right.
And he was denied them based on someone's opinion that he cannot comment on religion, but other people can. And yes, it's taxpayer money, but it's taxpayers who should then stop electing people.
Right.
And stop putting these laws in place. And if the state of Kentucky was actually concerned about taxpayer money, they would have given him his license plate and not allowed it to get to this level where they spent taxpayer money to pursue the lawsuit, and now they're spending more taxpayer money because they've lost.
Yep. So you don't want to pay stupid fees for stupid lawsuits, then stop electing stupid politicians with stupid Christian ideologies. You know, that is, you know, then maybe the taxpayers, if they care about this, they will be more motivated not to have elect officials that would do something stupid like this. Somebody actually responded to Frank as well, saying they should elect better government officials, exactly what Rivka said. Kimberly is saying, nah, he got paid back for having to pay for this, for that atrocious taxpayer arc. No, okay, I'm not gonna read that. But another thing is that if you think that...
Oh, the arc.
Yeah, so if you guys think that this the government money shouldn't have been spent on this, I think government money should be spent upholding people's rights. I mean, that's the whole point of having a government, is to support, to uphold people's rights. Like, is that, like, I mean, what else, if you think this was this money should have been spent, what if the government came and, like, took you away, you know, did something against your free speech? What if they, you know, against due process? Shouldn't they be challenged on that because it's expensive? I mean, that's the entire purpose of having a government. So if you want to pay a cost to remind them of what their purpose is, I think that's a cost worth, you know, paying, right? So
yeah, and you know what? A lot of people might not agree with me on this, but I just want to shout out to lawyers and attorneys as well. There's a huge number of them that are also holding back that dam of, you know, this crushing infringement on not only the separation between church and state, but our civil liberties, our First Amendment rights. And I, for one, am very thankful and always speak well of attorneys. Well, because they're doing a lot of good work.
Okay, but again, hashtag not all. Again.
That's true, but a lot of attorneys are doing a lot of work that people do not give them the credit and the recognition for.
I just get very, I just something.
Of course, it's not every attorney. There's some that are ambulance chasers, but I think that as adults, we can understand that when I say attorneys, I don't mean every single attorney.
You have too much of an expectation for the average adult. I have to
point. I mean, the people who are watching our show.
No, but I have to honestly. I have to point out the most basic things on our show every time. That a lot of people say, Armin, why are you saying this? Of course, that. Like, because people are morons. Okay, I have to. I have to assume that the average person is a moron. It's not an insult. It's just fact. Okay. It's not their fault. Usually it's genetics, it's environment, but sometimes people are just morons.
Gene environment correlation.
Yeah. And you just have to help them stop being morons. Okay. You just need some extra help. Anyways, that was our last news. Thank you for joining us. Subscribe to our channel. Hit the bell thingy. If you haven't, I don't know why. What's holding you back? Okay? If you haven't subscribed to our channel, why haven't you subscribed to our channel? Explain that to us, please. Like, bell, and also, if you're not getting notifications and stuff because YouTube is not telling people that we have shows, because YouTube is like, oh, this person told us that they want to get your shows, right? They want to get your videos, but nah. We think it's no. And they also hit the bell button, but nah, you guys are too controversial. We want to show them mainstream stuff. We want to show them CNN or cat videos or whatever. But people are like, no, we want to see Atheist Republic. And YouTube is like, nah, we don't think you want this. They're like, no, please show it to us. We say to you, we want to see Atheist Republic. And YouTube is like, no, we think we know what's better for you than you yourself. So to solve that, there's a link in the description, which is to our newsletter. So hopefully we could email it to you. So hopefully you get some of our content that way. Okay. So yeah, subscribe to our newsletter as well. And share our videos, because, you know, we do get demonetized. That's an obvious on every one of our videos. So F that, but we don't care about that anymore. But we also get deprioritized, and that's even more damaging to us. Deprioritized, what does that mean? That means we don't show up on the suggested, you know, videos on the right and all that, you know, on people's homepages. And that's how channels grow. Unfortunately, we can't grow. So we need you guys to share our videos so we can finally grow our YouTube. Like, look
you're
at us.
Like our vitamins when you share, when we grow.
Yes. So look at our Facebook. On our Facebook, we're like plus 2,300,000. And our YouTube is like 16,700. They're like, what the? Why can't we grow? Because we came to the YouTube game too late before the algorithm changed. So we need your help to grow on YouTube. Angel gave us another super chat.
Angel
is our savior because we don't get monetized. So we need
She's
our angel. Angel is saying, love you guys. See you next week. Oh, thank you, Angel.
Love you
as well. And thank you. Okay, see you guys next week. Bye.
Bye.
Atheists are under attack in many places. If they were Christians, their voices would be heard. If they were Jews, their voices would be heard. If they were Muslims, their voices would be heard. But they are atheists, and not many seem to be listening. Let's make it difficult for them to ignore us. We have built a global community, and now we are tearing down geographic, cultural, and language barriers so we can find each other and support each other. In the last decade, we have built the largest atheist community in the world. Now we're doing the same in other languages. With your help, we have started Atheist Republic in Persian and Arabic.
انضميت مؤخرا لأسرة Atheist Republic وحيصير عندي بودكاست باللغة العربية.
As we grow, we can dedicate more time, staff, and resources to start doing the same in Spanish, Portuguese, Malay, Bengali, Urdu, Hindi, and other languages. We are providing community, support, informative content, and amplifying the voices of those who need protection, especially in countries where people feel isolated simply for their lack of belief. We want to be there for them, and we are only getting started. Help us get there. Check in the description for ways you can support our projects.